back to our channel TechnoMonk, where we learn ServiceNow with ease. Have you ever struggled with managing ServiceNow development across multiple environments or on your PDAs? Because the PDAs get vanished in 10 days, right? Or felt frustrated when tracking changes manually? What if I told you that there is an easier way to automate deployments, collaborate beta, and improve version control, all with GitHub integration? So in today's tutorial, we'll be looking into how we can integrate ServiceNow with GitHub. So let me tell you about my journey. A few years ago, I was working on a major ServiceNow project where multiple developers were working on the same on different instances. We had no proper version control, and every change had to be manually copied and pasted between environments. One wrong move and we had overwrite someone's work. It was chaos until we discovered ServiceNow GitHub integration. This changed everything. We automated deployment, tracked every change in GitHub, and even set up continuous integration to deploy updates seamlessly. Today, I'm going to walk through every step you need to do in order to set up your integration with ServiceNow to GitHub. Stick around till the end because I'll be sharing some pro tips, okay? Best practice and troubleshoot steps to make your ServiceNow GitHub integration smooth and efficient. So let's get started. So this is my personal development instance, which is on Yokohama release, okay? And first, what we'll do, we'll create a scoped application because we have to work on the scoped application to have a source control. So I will just go to Studio and we'll create some dummy application itself. So I'll go. This is, and here you can see all the applications which are there currently. Okay. And if you see this particular status out, that means this applications are not connected to any source control. You can see not linked to source control. So we'll create a new application and we'll give it a name. What name we should give? It's taking some time. Let's start. I'll give the name as GitHub integration. And this is a demo app for GitHub integration. And I will do create. I'll give any role, for example, I'll give admin only for now. Admin, continue, classic, continue. I'm just creating any dummy application, okay? Nothing needs to be worried about this application. Table, I will just give the task table, okay? What is that task? Task. Let's take problem or let's take incident, okay? Incident table. Done with tables. And we can just start. This is great. So now our application is done, okay? We have created our application. Now what we'll do, we will select this particular application, GitHub integrations. Now if we go to the source control, we get the option to have link to source control. Now when we go for this, it asks for a couple of information over here. You can do either HTTPS or SSH. So we need UI, credentials. If we go to credentials, there is nothing right now, okay? Branch, mid server, default email ID, and so on and so forth. So we have to just fill up this information, get this information, and we are good to go. So what I will do, I will just go to, this is my GitHub. We have already logged into the GitHub and I will create a new repository and I will give it a name as GitHub integration. Okay. GitHub integration. Okay. This is a demo repo for GitHub. ServiceNow integration. I will keep it everything as is. I will create a repository. And as soon as we create the repository, we get this particular URL, right? The repository got created and we got this particular URL. So HTTPS, we'll just copy this out. This is one of the things which we require. So I will just go and paste it over here. The next thing what we want is credentials, right? Currently, we don't have the credentials. So we have to just go to ServiceNow and we have to search for what? It got stuck. I'll just refresh this page. Let me just refresh. Okay, perfect. So we'll go to all and we have to do connections. And connection and credentials, in that you have to go for credentials. I'll go here and we need to create a new credential, right? So I will click on new and we'll be going with the basic auth. Where is the basic auth? Basic auth credential. Okay. Now I will give GitHub. Okay. And in username, what you have to do? If you go to your profile, you can see this particular name right at the top. So this is your username. So it's Ami Gujarati. I'll paste it out. Now password is not the password which you are using to log into the system. Okay. It's a different password. So what you have to do? If you go to profile, okay. Just over here, you have to just go to settings. In settings, if we scroll down. Where? We should have developer settings, right? In developer settings, we had a personal access token. If you go to token classic, here I've created one for Hack October last year. Okay. Now you will create a generate new token. Generate new token classic, I will select. And you can give it a note as ServiceNow. Now demo. Okay. And I will keep the expiration for 7 days. Why? Because I will not be masking anything out till the time this particular video will go live. This token will get expired. Isn't it funny, right? I will give whatever required access is there. So I will give repo access. I will give write package access. I will give some admin access. Admin public access. What else? I will give project access. Yeah, I think that should be more than enough. I will do the generate the token. So this is how you will get the token. You just copy this token out, go back to basic auth profile, password, save, and make sure this active checkbox is checked. And I will just save this out. Now once you saved, you go back over here, credentials. Now you should be able to see one GitHub account. Perfect, right? Branches, this particular thing, if you want to change the branch name, you can do that, but I will keep it as is for now. No need to select mid server, no need to have email ID for now. And commit comments, this comment is from demo application. You can give anything, okay? And I will do link to source control. So let's see if we are able to successfully link or not. Okay, to the source control. So we have successfully committed the code. It was pretty simple, right? People are so worried. It's GitHub integration and so on and so forth. Okay, how we can do that on all those things out. So once you do that, what I'll do, let's verify the things out. So I will just go home. Okay. And in that, I have so many repositories, oh my word. What was the repository name? Something demo, right?
award.
It got created 2022. Which one I've created recently? This is fun. I just forgot that name or not. Oh, I can check it from here, right? Close control, edit repository configuration. It was GitHub integration. Okay. So I can go GitHub integration. This was the repository. And now you can see we had one recent push. Okay. If I do compare and pull. Okay. Oh yeah. And this is a branch from where it came. 218920. If I click over here, and you will be able to see all my things. Okay, what all things got pushed from here. Okay, all these things. Right? So we got all the code. Now how we can merge it out also, we will see. So if I go back to GitHub integration, you have to just compare and pull request, and you can create a pull request. Then the code will start getting merged. So this is how you can integrate ServiceNow with GitHub. Let's wait. Hang in there while we check the branch status. Yes, you can. We can also close the pull request after it got merged. Okay. So, and there you have it, a complete guide to ServiceNow GitHub integration. By following these steps, you can automate deployment, improve collaboration, and enhance security. If you found this particular video helpful, hit the like button, subscribe, and drop a comment with your questions. Until next time, keep innovating with ServiceNow. Thank you.